This is my Podmic, and this is my second Podmic. I discovered a grounding issue with one of them, and in this video, I'm going to show you how I fixed it. So if you have the same problem, keep watching. That was actually the noise that I was hearing, so I definitely knew that it was a grounding issue. Once I held it like this and grounded the XLR cable to the body, the noise disappeared. So there was something off with the connector, and the other Podmic did not have the same issue. So I knew there was something with the XLR grounding and the body. Now, you don't have to remove the side screws and the shims or the rubber thingies. There were quite a lot. I just wanted to check it out. I eventually screwed them back on. The screw that we are going to have to wrestle with is the three-hole security or tamper-proof screw. I tried several ways of removing this screw, but I eventually decided to go with the drill bit and remove it with a regular flathead screwdriver. Okay, so I put the mic in a vise. I just clamped it down, and then I checked if I was correct about the grounding. Now, when I touch the ground pin of the XLR, the grill or the body of the mic should ground. But in this test, it didn't. So I knew there was something wrong here. Now, before drilling into the microphone or the security screw, I covered the mic in a plastic bag, then ripped a hole around the area where I was going to drill and masked it off with masking tape. I took the smallest drill bit I could find or drill, and using one of the pre-existing holes in the security screw and then drilling another hole on opposite side. And just to minimize the amount of brass debris, I vacuumed in between, going deeper and deeper with the drill bit, so it wouldn't get too messy. Okay, so when I was happy about the holes that I had drilled, I opened up between the holes so that I could fit a drill bit inside of it, and then used the screwdriver and released the screw. And here you have the screw with the spring. And it serves two purposes. Once I saw this, I immediately understood that this is something off. This is how they solved the grounding thing from the XLR jack to the outer case, because in between there's plastic. So once you screw this in, it holds the whole capsule in place, and it also serves as a grounding for the outer casing to the XLR jack. And it's just a matter of pulling the capsule out, and we can start looking at what is wrong with it. And I was right all along. Clap your hands. This hole here, this is where the ground pin goes down through the body down to the ground pin of the XLR. So I looked down and I saw a white cable. One of the signal cables coming from the XLR cable came in between the spring and the metal lip of the XLR jack. So of course it wasn't grounding. Here's a look at how it's supposed to look if it's grounding. I just took the prongs or the pokers, and sure enough, that's grounding. But the white cable was in the way, and I'm going to demonstrate that right now, putting the spring and screw down. It's supposed to ground just the same, but it doesn't. So that just confirms my theory here. So my fix for this particular situation was to twist and turn the signal cables from the XLR jack before inserting it again, at the same time looking down the hole to see if anything was in the way or if I could see the metal. If I saw the metal, it was good and I could just screw it back on. It's a tiny flathead screw. Now, doing this, you want to make sure that neither of the blue or white cables pushes away the spring, because then you have the same problem again. You wouldn't want that in a podcast or a live stream. But yeah, this is what you have to think about when you're pushing back the XLR jack. You might have to repeat this process a couple of times, meanwhile looking down the hole and see if any of the cables come in the way. But check that with a multimeter and then you're okay to just reassemble and push it back in and screw it back on using the same method backwards. And here I'm pulling the spring just a little bit, just to make it a little bit longer before I put it back in. And there you go. But before I'll test the microphone, I'm gonna check with the multimeter and just to make sure that it's grounding. So here I'm poking the screw, the holes that I've drilled, and the ground pin. And yeah, sure enough, it goes to zero, which it didn't do before. So it is grounding. So let's see how it sounds. I'll use the same XLR cable going into the same channel as I had recording the noise. Seems to be sounding just fine. And when I touch the body, now I'm really loud in my headphones, but I really want to make sure that I hear if I hear the same issue that I had before. But now I'm kind of far away from the mic. Now I'm really up close. It's really super loud. Now it sounds like it should sound. It didn't sound like this before. You can hear machines in the background. My gain is way up. And now, yeah, I do not get the same grounding noise. I have fixed the mic. Basically, this was a super easy fix. So yeah, I'm stoked, I'm happy, and unfortunately I've destroyed the screw. I've totally wrecked the screw, but hey, this is just gonna be covered up by a small dot or something, so it's not a huge deal. You could turn this mic around, hide this dot if you want to use it the other way around. And now the only problem is the the Rode logo is upside down, but that I don't really care. It doesn't matter. The mic is equally the same the other way around. I'm gonna switch to the other mic so you can hear if there's any difference whatsoever. And I've got that one on the boom arm coming down here. Try not to knock down the camera, but yeah, I've got it on the boom arm, and I'm just gonna plug that in real quick. Laundry machine is done. So this is the one that I've had, and I've used this one primarily. It's got the puff hood, the windshield, the coming up close, taking away plosives, taking away. This one has no ground issue whatsoever, like the other one had. Like this one had, it had this weird buzzing, but I'm super happy. Didn't have to ship it away and get it fixed by Rode. And yeah, super happy. All right, that's all for now.